What's going on, guys? Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to Amigoscode. In this video, I want to talk to you whether you can learn how to code through YouTube tutorials. So this is a question that I get asked quite a lot, and I feel like, let me just address this question and make sure that when you watch a tutorial on YouTube, then you know exactly what to do and how to take advantage of these video tutorials. Now, YouTube is an amazing platform for pretty much learning anything, especially coding, right? So you lot are learning how to code, you want to become programmers, and this is pretty much one of the best places. And the cool thing is that it's free. The cool thing is that it's free. So before I kick off, I just want you to take 2 seconds, literally 2 seconds, and smash that like button. Literally, just give me a thumbs up, because it means a lot when you smash that like button and I can keep on providing you guys with content like this. So take 2 seconds. It doesn't hurt. It's free. Give me a thumbs up. And if you're not part of the Amigoscode community, go ahead and join both Discord and the private Facebook group, over 30,000 people combined. So how can you take advantage when learning how to code through YouTube? So this is a question that a lot of you guys ask me, and just to put it this way, I think that if you are learning how to code by just watching the video and then trying to implement, right? So watching the video, following along line by line, and then if you want to take, for example, what you've learned from the video and then, put it in your own project or your own company, let's say, then it's not going to work. And this is because every scenario is different. So you see, sometimes the projects that I build or the ideas that I have to teach you how to code is because I'm thinking of something that will be helpful to you so that you can use that as a starting point, and not so that you can take the exact same code and then use it on your own project, right? So that way, it's not going to work, because you're kind of just copying my code into whatever you want to put it, right? And that way you're not learning anything. Like, literally, you're not learning anything, right? So if I was to, for example, say, can you then implement something else? Then you would say, wow, okay, so how do I then, you know, try and change this code to adapt to mine? Usually it doesn't work like that, right? So this is something that I feel like a lot of you are getting wrong, and you should just use these tutorials as a mean of understanding certain concepts, right? And then what I would do is, yes, you can, you know, try and learn line by line and then execute it and see it working, but then have a real project. Right. So build a real project where you can use whatever you've learned from the tutorial itself, and then try to integrate. Right. Not just copy and pasting from the tutorial into your repo or your own application, because that way you're not learning anything. And the whole purpose of YouTube really is just to give you free content. You're right, you're watching this video, it's free, you're not paying anything, and there are really good tutorials out there, but they won't teach you, for example, how to build your own application from scratch. Because if you want to build, let's say, your own application within your own niche, then it's really specific to what you're trying to build, right? It's really specific of what you're trying to build. So take these tutorials to understand the concept, and don't take these tutorials to take the code and then put it in your own application, because that is wrong, right? So there are times where I used to say, oh, do you know what? I've learned how to use this concept, right? But then if I wanna pretty much just code it myself, I wouldn't know where to start. And this is the problem. The problem is that you are trying to think how you can take this exact same code that you've just watched and put it in your code, right? Whereas you should be thinking, okay, so now I've understood the concept. Now let me go and try and implement it. And what I wanna tell you is that coding is the easiest part. Trust me, like, when it comes to programming, the most difficult thing is not it's not like, you know, writing the classes, the packages, you know, putting the application together. No, right? That's not the most difficult part. So there are a bunch of other things that you need to consider when it comes to, you know, build a solid backend, right? So for example, how do you model your data in the database, right? How do you handle the security part, right? The infrastructure. So how you want your code to handle multiple or million requests, right? So there are other things, for example, CI, CD, how do you make sure that your application is always deploying, right? You know, testing, right? How do you make sure that your tests run fast, right? Because, you know, there are other things that you should be really worrying when it comes to, you know, build software, and you are just thinking on a small subset, right? And usually I tell my students, you know, coding is the easiest bit, and they say, oh, no. Coding is the hardest bit. But as you become more experienced and then become a senior engineer, you will not be doing as much coding as before, because your job will be actually now to be involved in the, you know, overall architectural design of the application, how different components work with each other, how do you handle, you know, failures, for example. You know, there are other things that you will basically be doing instead of just coding every single time, right? Because then you kind of done over and over again, and you kind of know how things work, and then you just want to move on, right? So the purpose of this video really is just to tell you that yes, you can learn coding from YouTube, but providing that you learn the concepts and then you go out there and build something on your own. So build your own project, right? So I've got a couple of students. Murillo is one good example. So on his GitHub, he has pretty much every single example, right? So every single tutorial that is done, he's got all the samples there, and he only uses those as a reference. So if he wants to build something, he kind of coded, right? So he did along with the instructor, which is good, right? So you're practicing as someone else is teaching. So that's a check. And then he also stored the examples. So that's another check. So that shows that, you know, Murillo is, you know, engaged, and he wants to learn, and he wants to basically just carry on improving, and he wants to show to other people that he's actually really passionate about it, right? And then from that, when it comes to build his own application or even at work, then you can just refer and look at, for example, how certain things are done, and not just, you know, take the exact same code and then put it in his own company or whatever project that he's working on, right? So I remember there was a video that I've done. I think it was the registration video. It was like a complete registration form system. And then someone else said, so how do you then, I think, log out, or how do you do something? And I'm like, I don't know what you're trying to do, right? So you need to use your own business logic, because at that point, it's just like business logic, right? I don't know the app that you're trying to build. I don't know the domain. It's something that I couldn't just say, okay, let me just code this, right? So again, use logic, use the videos as a guide, and don't rely too much on them, because these videos are just here to show you, the concepts and to get you off the ground. But then you should be the one taking your own project from scratch, going and understanding the concept, putting things together, you know, finding errors. So learning through errors is another one. So you should really be, stumbling upon errors, right? Because if, let's say, I've done some tutorial, I already planned what I want to code, right? I already done it in advance. It's not like I'm just a genius. It's not like that, right? So usually when you code, you encounter errors all the time. But when I record the videos, I make it seem like, oh, this, you know, works first time, because I already planned everything in advance, right? I've gone through the errors, I've Googled it, I went to Stack Overflow, and I'm actually learning through building new content for you, right? And what I don't want you to do is to, you know, just rely on these videos and on my courses to basically take the exact same code and then use it, right? So that's not what I want, you know, for you guys to do. I want you to, you know, become a software engineer that will have the understanding, will have the knowledge, and a software engineer that can tackle any problem, right? So, you know, working with different companies, you know, you'll never find that, you know, the same, you'll never find basically the same code. People have different ways of tackling problems. And programming is just like, you know, it's just a way of you solving problems. And this is something that you should think on how to improve, right? So how do I solve problems? And not just think about the syntax, the code, because that's like, as I said, that's not the most important thing. So coding is the easiest part. So let me know what you thought about this video. If you're new to my channel, give me a thumbs up, and I'll catch you on the next one. Assalamu alaikum.